Everyone, my name is Ananya Rajput, a legal intern at LEXIS AND COMPANY. So today, in this video, I'm going to talk about dowry laws in India. Now, there is hardly any other malady of greater magnitude which the society is facing today than the curse of dowry demand and dowry death. It is commonly talked of in the society that newly married wife is expected to be a gold mine, falling for which they treat her as the combustible name material, and because of the cruel behavior, the girl who comes to the matrimonial home with great expectations and dreams had to resort to suicide or to be burnt alive by the in-laws. Now, it is ironic that in India, dowry was originally designed to safeguard the woman, and it was the provision of stri dhan in the form of money, property or gifts given solely to the woman by her parents at the time of her marriage. Now, stri dhan, an inheritance, was meant to exclusively belong to the woman at the time of her marriage. The abuse of this custom eroded and aborted the original meaningful function of the dowry as the safety net of the women, and was the corrupted to become the price tag for the groom and consequently the noose for the bride. Now, the government has tried to combat the growing incidence of the dowry death by enacting various laws to prevent such deaths from occurring and to punish those who are responsible when they do occur. Now, the government's first effort came with the Dowry Prohibition Act of 1961. To increase its effectiveness, the government has twice amended the act in 1984 and 1986. Now, the 1986 amendment required the police and the judicial magistrate to investigate every unnatural death of the woman married less than 7 years. Currently, the act prohibits the giving, taking or demanding of the dowry. The act defines dowry as the property that is given or agreed to to be given to a newlywed by the other newlywed or either sets of parents in connection with the marriage. Violation of the act are punishable with the term of imprisonment of between 6 months and 2 years, plus a fine of up to 10,000 rupees or the value of the dowry, whichever is higher. Now, in spite of legal breakthroughs, shocking statistics on dowry deaths continue to show up in the Indian newspaper. The 90s showed a steady yearly increase in bridal death tolls, with many more deaths unreported. Like clockwork, every 12 hours, a dowry-related death claimed to have taken the lives of over 20,000 women across India between 1990 and 1993. And the dowry death statistical beat goes up to higher. Now, total of 2,988 dowry death cases are pending in the High Court all over the country. In addition, 13,251 dowry death cases are pending in the subordinate court throughout the country. The highest number of dowry death cases, comprising 926 such cases, are pending in the Rajasthan High Court, followed by 842 such cases in the Punjab and Haryana High Court, 436 cases in the Bombay High Court, 397 cases in the Madhya Pradesh High Court, 141 cases in the Himachal Pradesh High Court, and the number goes on and on. While no time limit has been prescribed by laws for courts to decide dowry deaths cases, both the government and the judiciary are concerned with the pendency of such cases. Meanwhile, various steps are being taken to expedite disposal of cases by the courts. These include amendment of the Code of Criminal Procedure, increase in the number of judges or judicial officers, appointment of special judicial and metropolitan magistrates, and setting up a fast-track court. In a case of Agla Ravinder versus State of AP, a sort of relief came against the possible misuse of Section 304B IPC, when it was held that death must be proved to be one of out of the course of nature, and mere fact that the deceased was young and death was not accidental is not sufficient to establish that death must have occurred otherwise than under normal circumstances. Thus, there are still many inconsistencies in laws related to dowry, which should be corrected to ensure its effective and fair implementation. But the evil of dowry is equally a matter of concern to the societies as a whole, and shall have to be curbed. For this, some steps may be taken, which we'll discuss. First, we will have to shift to our ancient value-based society, where the women were respected as equally as men, perhaps more than men. The women need to be well educated and economically independent at the various levels of the society. We hear no cases of bride burning in the Western countries because their women are well educated and economically independent. In Dowry theft cases, the police investigation should be prompt and impartial instead of being corrupted and sloppy. As recommended by the Supreme Court in the case of Bhagwat Singh versus Commissioner of Police, more women police officers should be involved for the proper investigation of crime against women. Moreover, there should not be unfortunate delay in the disposal of the dowry theft cases. Guilty should be punished while events are still fresh in the public mind, so that it can work as a deterrent for the society. For this purpose, special courts may also be established. Within the purview of law, registration of marriage together with the list of gifts should be made compulsory. Provision must be made that any gift matter after the marriage should also be included in the list. Dowry is a social scourge, and public opinion has to be mobilized against this cancerous evils. It cannot be contained by only legal and police action. The memorable words of Mahatma Gandhi, acceptance of dowry is a disgrace to the young man who accepts it, as well as perhaps a dishonor for a woman, folk who should ring the ear in every unmarried young man or woman. The educated youth can contribute tremendously in curbing this evil if they try to implement and practice the education which they are given. Besides of general literacy, legal literacy program should also be started to make the women of the downtrodden class aware of their legal rights. And all this voluntary organization can play an important role. Thus, vigorous investigation and prosecution, realistic punishment of the offender, along with a determined reawakening movement to curb the evil are required. There are no shortcut and flashy solutions of this deep-seated social malaise. Thank you.